giving with generosity. There are those that have a gift of giving. He tells you how to give generously. And this person earns 50,000 naira as a salary. And next thing you see in your account, 30,000. Big amount like this. You're wondering how. They didn't give 2,000. They didn't give 5,000. That's not how it works in them. Now, I know the better example if I'm to go with what we read in the scripture. So like Barnabas, that I think Ananias and Sapphira were trying to copy. He sold the field and gave all. He sold it 3 million. He could have given 1.5 million to the pastors and they took it and administered it. He didn't do that. He gave the 3 million. That's why Ananias and Sapphira, hypocrites, sold their own 3 million and came and said, oh, there's this land we sold for 2.8 million. So we said we should bring all. Peter said, even when you sold it, the money was your own. It was your own. Why do you lie? You should have just said, I sold it 3 million. So we said we want to give the majority to the church. Since you must announce, since you must tell us it's all, why do you lie? He would have given, God would have been happy. But he connived with the tribe. He said, when they ask you, tell them it's 2.82. But why? You see the deception in the heart. And some people say all sorts of things, that they were not stingy. They were generous, but they were deceitful. And God does not like deceit. So he says, when you're giving, give with generosity. Hear me carefully. Who is giving with generosity? Is it everybody here or those with the gift of giving? That doesn't mean you shouldn't give generously, because the Bible clearly says in 1 Corinthians 9 that he that gives generosity will reap generously, okay? The Bible tells you this. If you sow sparingly, you reap sparingly. Generally, you should try and be generous. But listen, it's not everyone that has the gift to give much. Why? The guy's salary is 25,000. It's not his gifting that much. You, your salary is 250,000. So you can give. But the guy that has 25,000 and gives 10,000 is more generous than the guy that has 250,000 and gives 80,000. I hope you understand that the ratio, the percentage is less for this guy, because it's a percentage thing. That's how you measure giving, generous giving. The woman in the synagogue that Jesus said she gave more than everyone else, she had 2 pennies, but she gave 100%. So it's in the percentage. That's the thing. So those that have a gift of giving have the capacity to give generously, because that's your calling. He tells you, if you're giving, please, your calling was to give. Give generously. How are you going to be giving generously when you're also selfish? It's either it's not your calling, and apart from that, you don't know how to be generous, or it's your calling, but you don't know how to walk in your calling. That's why he didn't say those that are to give, give. He explained, if your calling is giving, you can't give small. You must give. It's not in the amount, it's in the percentage. So even though you have a 25,000 naira salary, God may place you in your heart, give 10,000 naira every month. Do it. God will take care of you with the rest. Another person may earn big, but he doesn't have a gift of giving. He just says, okay, when I give at least 10% and I give more on top of that, I'm fine. Okay, that's a choice. One of the ways I think people are called to giving as a calling is that they have much. I think one of the clearest signs that you're given a gift of giving is that you have the ability to give. The people with the other gifts, that they had an ability, that the prophesying person found something bubbling up out of their heart and mouth, that the teaching person found himself always desiring to help people understand things, explain things. You find it in you. In the same way, those often called to giving tend to have more given to them. Remember, freely you have received, freely give. Usually the sign of your gifting is that you have the capacity to do it. So that capacity to clean another, it's given to you from God, from your shaping, even your environment, how you grew up. You find yourself, oh, you can't see dust, please, is there a rag? You find yourself suddenly you're tidying up. It's just, you're not going like, ah, this is so hard. Mm-mm. It's much more easy. Another person doesn't even see what you're seeing, doesn't even see the problem, not to talk about thinking of solving it. In the same way, one of the ways you know someone is called to give is usually that they receive more.